So now, today we discuss about the normal form. So in previous class we discussed what is a propositional variable and what is the utility of the proposition variable in discrete mathematics. So in that truth table we can say if there, we can take a proposition variable P and we can take a P or negation P. So P or negation P, we can, with the help of truth table, we can find it is a tautology. Means both the value we can generate as a true. So to construct a truth table, we can take it is the values true and false. Negation P, it is just negation false and it is true. P or negation P, it is true or false true, and false and true, it is also true. So that is called as a tautology. But if suppose the variable is a large number of variables, suppose 6 variable and 7 variable, so it is very difficult to construct a truth table. So what we can do, we can introduce the concept of normal form. So in normal form, here we can know, before starting to the normal form, we use the term conjunction and disjunction. So here conjunction, it is treated as a, it is treated as a and, and disjunction is or. So it is disjunction, it is nothing but it is called as a sum, and conjunction means it is a product. So before starting to the conjunction and disjunction, we can take what is a elementary sum and elementary product. So elementary sum is nothing but it is a sum of variable, sum of proposition variable and the negation. Like that, we can take a negation P or Q, or negation P or Q, or P or negation Q. That term is called as an elementary sum. What is the elementary product? Elementary product is nothing but a proposition variable and a negation. They represent in the form of product form. So like that, it is a negation P, or we can call as a P and Q, P and negation Q, negation P and Q. So that form is called as a elementary product. So now, we can come to the point, what is the normal form in which we can reduce the form in such a way that we can construct without using the truth table when the variable is so large. So first we can start with the conjunction normal form. So here are two type of form of normal form. One is the disjunctive normal form and another is the conjunctive normal form. So we can start with the disjunctive normal form. So what is the disjunctive normal form? So if A is a formula is given and we can say it is equivalent to B. When A formula, it is equivalent to B only if B is in the form of sum of elementary product. It is in the form of sum of elementary product. So we can say it is the form of disjunctive normal form. So disjunctive normal form, a formula which is equivalent to another formula, and then another formula is in the form of sum of elementary product. It is called as a disjunctive normal form. In the case of disjunctive normal form, we can say any parenthesis we can write P and P implies Q. And we want to convert into the disjunctive normal form. First and foremost thing is that we can remove implication, biconditional, and replace with, remove this with conjunction, disjunction, and negation. So our thing is that any formula we want to convert into the disjunctive normal form, we can, what we can convert, we can convert this implication, we can convert this biconditional in the form of conjunction, disjunction, and negation. Then we can apply the De Morgan theorem or distributive theorem or distributive law whenever it is necessary. So whenever it is necessary, the De Morgan and distributive law we can apply, and we can conclude the final equivalent formula, which is in the form of sum of elementary product. So now we can take what are the example of disjunctive normal form. It is also called as a DNF. So what are the example in which we can say that form is belong to DNF? So suppose we can take a P or Q. It is the form of DNF in P and Q, or negation P and Q, it is also in the form of sum of elementary product, because this is indicate for the sum and this is indicate for the product. So as we can told earlier, this is indication for the conjunction, and conjunction nothing but it is the form of product, and this is the disjunction, it is in the form of sum. So sum of elementary product, that is the in the form of DNF. Now another example we can take P and negation P, or negation P and negation Q. It is also in the example of disjunctive normal form. Now we can take another example, P and Q and R, or negation P and Q. Or negation R. So these are the examples in which we can say that is the example of disjunctive normal form. And as we see that all the form which is in the form of sum of elementary product. So here in the case of P or Q, it is only two proposition variable P or Q. But whenever we can give in the form of mean term and max term, we can convert in the form of elementary. Sum of elementary product. So now we can give some example and some problem how the formula we can reduce in a logical equivalent form based on the disjunctive normal form. So we can take it few problems. So now the problem is that it is the first problem we can take P implies Q and it is negation Q. It is the form in which we can convert this form into the disjunctive normal form. So as we can do it earlier, what we can do, first we can remove this implication by the conjunction, disjunction or negation. So as we know that P implies Q, which is equal to negation P or Q, so it is automatically that implementation convert into the form of disjunction, negation P or Q. So here we can write this form into negation P or Q and negation Q. So now this form is called as a, we can convert into this, into remove the implication. Now we can apply distributive law, and distributive law says A and B or C equal to A, it is like that, we can say A or C and B or C. So we can just convert in the form of implication, we can say that is negation P and negation Q, or Q and negation Q. So now this form, it is in the form of disjunctive normal form. So here we can say that form, it is in the required disjunctive normal form, because it is a sum, it is an elementary product. It is a product, it is a product, it is in the form of sum. So now this is the sum of elementary product. Now we can take the another example. It is the first example. Now we can take the another example in which we can say it is a P and P implies Q. It is P and P implies Q. So the same thing we can perform, we can just remove here, as we know P implies Q, which is equal to negation P or Q. So we can put here P and negation P or Q. Now apply distributive law. So after apply the distributive law, we can say it is equal to P and negation P or P and Q. So, in the form of, we can convert the reduced step into the required disjunctive normal form, we can use the concept of law of logic. We can apply the De Morgan law, we can just convert into the, we can apply the distributive law, and then we can solve this expression. So this is also in the required disjunctive normal form. So in that way, any expression is given, how we can convert into the form of disjunctive normal form. So now another example we can take, P and Q. Now the next example, we have to take P and Q, then or it is negation, P implies Q. So that is a form we can reduce into the logical equivalence, based on the logical equivalence convert into the required disjunctive normal form. So here P implies Q equal to negation P or Q. We can substitute here, it is P and Q or negation P or Q. Now, here, what the law we can apply, it is, as we know, the negation of P or Q, which is equivalent to negation P and negation Q. So here, again we can apply in this way, we can apply the De Morgan law. So apply De Morgan law and we get in above equation it is P and Q or negation of negation P and negation Q, which is nothing but P and Q or P and negation Q. So this is the expression in the form of required DNF, disjunctive normal form. And as we know, one point in your, remember in your mind, the disjunctive normal form is not a unique. Disjunctive normal form is not unique. If suppose we can generate more than one disjunctive normal form for the same equation. So, this is the one example. We can take one more example to more clarify about the how the equation should be converted to the required disjunctive normal form. So we can take even more example. Now the next example is, it is negation of P and Q and P implies Q. Now we want to convert this expression into the required disjunctive normal form. So here we can take P implies Q. First we can convert the implication and biconditional in the form of conjecture and disjunction, and then we can apply the De Morgan law. So P implies Q, we know it is logical equivalent to negation P or Q. So here we can substitute the in the equation, this above equation, negation P and Q and negation P or Q. Now what we can take the next step, we can apply the distributive law. So apply distributive law in negation P and Q and negation P or negation P and Q and Q. Afterwards, what we can do, it is negation P and Q and negation P and negation P and Q and Q. So now next we can just solve negation P and negation P and Q or negation P and Q and Q. We can apply the associative law, apply using associative law. We find it is negation P and negation P. And negation P and negation P, what we can generate, it is nothing but negation P. It is the idempotent law.
Item one is what we can say, P and P equal to P. That is idempotent. We can apply here, we get negation P and Q or negation P and Q. So negation P and Q or negation P and Q, it is in the form of, we can call it as a, it is a required disjunctive normal form. So what we get, it is in sum and it is an elementary product. So all the equation we can come in the form of sum of elementary product. So I think you are clear about the concept. The disjunctive normal form, any equation is given, first we can convert in the form of conjunction, disjunction and negation, and then we can apply the De Morgan law or distributed or associative, whatever the law is necessary, we can apply here and finally convert into the form of sum of elementary product. So when the formula come under the sum, that is the sum of elementary product, then the form is called as a required disjunctive normal form. So that is about the disjunctive normal form. Now the next portion we can say convert about the conjunctive normal form. So next, conjunctive normal form, it is called as a CNF. So in conjunctive normal form, we say that any formula A is given and the another formula B which is equivalent to A, another formula B which is equivalent to A, when B is in the form of product of elementary sum, that is called as a POS. So when the B equivalent formula, it is come under the product of elementary sum, it is called as a, it is a conjunctive normal form. So the conjunctive normal form, a formula which is equivalent to the another formula which is in the form of product of elementary sum, that is called as a conjunctive normal form. So how the given formula we can convert into the conjunctive normal form, that is the few steps. First step is that we can convert implication by conditional into the conjunction, disjunction and negation. Then we can apply again the law of logic, whatever the law we can necessary, we can apply into the equation, and finally we can generate the equation which is in the form of product of elementary sum. So now one we can take, what are the few examples we can take, which is the form, the equation we can say it is in the form of conjunctive normal form. So the example of conjunctive normal form. So example of conjunctive normal form is that it is, we can take P and Q, or P or Q and negation P or Q, or P or Q or R and negation P or Q and negation R, and P or negation P and P and negation Q, or negation P and negation Q. So that is in the example in which we can say that the form is called in the conjunctive normal form. So why it is conjunctive normal form? So in the previous example we can discuss about the disjunctive normal form. Here we can use the conjunction term. In the case of conjunctive normal form, it is a product, it is a sum. So product of elementary sum. But in the case of disjunctive normal form, we can write here the P and Q, or negation P and negation Q. So it is in the form of sum, it is in the form of product. So sum of elementary product, that is called in the case of disjunctive normal form. But in the case of conjunctive normal form, it is a product and it is a sum. So product of elementary sum. So the important thing is that you should know, in the disjunctive normal form, they are represented in the sum of elementary product, and this conjunctive normal form we can represent in the product of elementary sum. So now we can take the few example how to reduce the given equation into the conjunctive normal form with the help of logical equivalence. So we can take a few examples in which we have to more clear about the concept. So we can take one example. First, P implies P and Q implies P. That is one problem in which we can convert this expression into the conjunctive normal form. So, what we can do, as we know, if P implies Q equal to negation P or Q, here we can use the two time implication and one is the conjunction. So what we can do, we can first innermost we can remove this implication by the conjunction. What we can do, we can take P implies P and it is a negation Q or P. Now this implication we want to remove. So how? It is negation of P or it is negation P and negation Q or P. So now here we can again apply the De Morgan law. How De Morgan law should be applied? As we know, the De Morgan law, it is negation P and Q, which is equivalent to negation P or negation Q. We can apply here law, it is called as a negation P, or it is a negation of negation P, or negation and negation Q or P. So it is negation P or P, or that is, again we can apply the theorem in the De Morgan law, again apply De Morgan law, it is indeed that it is negation of negation Q and negation P. So it is negation P or Q and negation P. So now, in that case, we can find how it will be converted in the form of disjunctive or in the form of conjunctive normal form. So now we can take negation P or P, then and negation P or Q or P. So now it is the way in which we can convert this final expression into this required conjunctive normal form. So now we can take a few more examples about how to convert this form into the disjunctive normal form. So now another example is that it is a P and P implies Q implies to Q. So now this is the next example in which we can convert into the form of conjunctive normal form. So what we can do, we can first convert this implication and then we can solve. So here we can take, as you know, P implies Q equal to negation P or Q. So it is a negation P and P implies Q or Q. Now this P implies Q, we want to solve it. Again negation P or Q, we can take P and negation P or Q or Q. Now in this case we can apply De Morgan theorem And as De Morgan's theorem says, negation P and Q, which is equal to negation P or negation Q. We can apply the theorem here. It is negation P or negation of negation P and Q. Or Q. So now, we can want to generate the final output. It is negation P. Or, here again we can apply the De Morgan theorem. It is negation of negation P and negation Q or Q using De Morgan law or De Morgan theorem. So it is negation P or P and negation Q or Q. So now this is the expression here in which we can say that expression is in the form of required conjunctive normal form. So what we can do, we can first convert this implication by the conjunction or disjunction, then we can apply the De Morgan theorem, again here we can apply the De Morgan theorem, and finally we can generate the equation which is in the form of conjunctive normal form. So now, after that, one thing you have to remember, that conjunctive normal form is not a unit, or disjunctive normal form also is not a unit. You can generate many ways to conjunctive normal form and many different ways to generate the disjunctive normal form. So that is about the conjunctive and disjunctive normal form. Now we can discuss about the principle of disjunctive normal form and principle of conjunctive normal form. So now is, principle of disjunctive normal form, and it is called as a also PDNF, principle of conjunctive normal form, which is also called as a PDNF. So in principle of disjunctive normal form, let the two proposition variable P and Q. In the P and Q two proposition variable, we can generate the total mean term, which is P and Q, P and negation Q, negation P and Q, negation P and negation Q. So these are called as a mean term. So if suppose there is an n number of variable, so how many total number of mean terms will be generated? 2 to the power n. So if suppose there is a 2 variable, we can generate 2 to the power 2 equal to 4 number of mean term. If suppose n variable, propositional variable are existing, then we can generate 2 to the power 3 is n number, 2 to the power n, that is 2 to the power 3, which is 8 proposition mean term. So if there is an n variable, generate 2 to the power n type of mean terms. So that is P and Q, it is in the form of conjunction. So here, in the principle of disjunctive normal form says, whatever the term we can find in the disjunctive normal form, only represent in the form of mean term. So it is just as a disjunctive normal form, but the term we can represent, the final principle of disjunctive normal form, it is in the form of mean term. That is in either P and Q, P and negation Q, negation P and Q. And there is no number of duplication. If suppose the duplication should be existing, we can avoid the duplicate entry. So this is the way in which we can find the principle of disjunctive normal form. So the resultant value, it is only consist of the mean term. So how we can find the principle of disjunctive normal form with truth table and without using the truth table? So one by one we can discuss how to convert into the with the help of truth table and how to help with the without truth table. So In that, if suppose we can take two proposition variable like P and Q, so how many number of values would be existing? One is the true true, true false, false true, and false false. So now, P and Q, P and negation Q, negation P and Q, negation P and negation Q. So here, in truth value, P and, this case, P and Q, both the true, the value become true, true false, value become false, it is false, it is false. In P and negation Q, both the values, it is true, it is false, negation, the resultant value become false. It is true, true, it is true, false, false, and it is also false, and it is false, false, true, false, and it is false, 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 and true. So you know, you observe that this table, in every combination, exactly one value is truth value is true, remaining all are the false. So here, in this P and Q, only this first value is true, remaining all are the false. In second combination, we can take P and negation Q. This one combination is exactly value true, remaining all are the false. In that negation P and Q, only one value, truth value is true, remaining all are the false. And negation P and Q, only one value, it is true, all other values are become false. So that is in the term of mean term, we can generate only exactly one value is true for all the combination, including variable itself. So, how the problem can be solved with the help of truth table to find the descent to normal form? We can take one example, P implies Q. So here, P implies Q, we know that it is negation P or Q. So now in P implies Q, we can generate with the help of truth table, we can take P, Q, and P implies Q. It is true, 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 false, false, true, and false, false. P implies Q says whether either both of the value become true, then it is true, or value of P become false, no matter what the value of Q has. So it is true, and it is false. So now what is a mean term? Next term we can take mean term. What is a mean term? You know, in this P and Q, the value become true. So when P and Q, the value become true only in the case of P and Q. So here mean term is P and Q. Now, next third one, false and true. When false and true, the value true, at that time, the mean term is negation P and Q. So here, we can write negation P and Q. When both the proposition variable truth value is false, it is false, false, then negation P and negation Q, in that mean term, the particular value become true. So here, we can take negation P and negation Q. So now, we know that it is a false, so P implies Q, which is equivalent to P and Q, or negation P and Q, or negation P and negation Q. So this is in the required form of PDNF, principle of disjunctive normal form. So that is, with the help of truth table, we can generate that particular formula P implies Q, which can be represented in the form of principle disjunctive normal form. So now the second thing is that how to convert without using the truth table. So that is the way in which we can use the truth table and truth table to find the mean term, whatever the value should be true. At the true value, we can generate the mean term, and based on the mean term, we can find this is in the form of principle disjunctive normal form. Another way in which we can find, that is with the help of law of logic, we can simplify the expression and we can convert into the finally principal disjunctive normal form. So now the another example we can take. Here we can also find, in that case we can just rough this one. And we can take here P biconditional Q. When a P biconditional Q, The truth value says, when both the truth values should be same, at that time, the resultant value become true. So either this one true and this one true. This is false, this is false. Now we can again generate the mean term of P by conditional Q. It is generate true true. At that time, it is P and Q. And at the last, it is negation P and negation Q. So we can say P by conditional Q, which is equivalent to P and Q, or negation P and negation Q. It is in the form of principal disjunctive normal form. So any implication, any biconditional, we can convert into the form of principal disjunctive normal form. So now this is with the help of truth table. Another way, without using the truth table, how to convert into the principal disjunctive normal form. So now we can start with a few problems which is without using constructing the truth table. We can create a principle of disjunctive normal form without using the truth table. So we can take an example P or negation Q. So we can find, this is a problem one. We can convert into the form of principal disjunctive normal form. So what we can do, we can take P and we can take Q or negation Q, or negation Q and P or negation P. So we can just convert P or negation Q in the form of this one. So, you know, P or negation P always come to the tautology. So we can just prove with the help of true and false. Negation P is a false and true, and this is the P or negation P become true and true. So it is a tautology. So it is just nothing but P and true, or negation Q or true. So negation Q or true is nothing but negation Q, and it is equivalent to P or negation Q. So P or negation Q we can write in this way. So now, next we can take how in the form of principal disjunctive normal form, what we can do, we can take here, we can apply again the distributive law. In this case, we can also apply the distributive law and we can find the finally generated result. So apply distributive law. So we can apply the distributive law, we get P and Q, or P and negation Q, or negation Q and P, or negation Q and negation P. So here in this case we can apply the distributive P and Q or negation Q. It is nothing but P and Q or P and negation Q. So distributive law, what the distributive law says, it is a A and B or C, which is equal to A and B or A and C. We can apply this law here. It is a negation Q. So now we can apply this law and apply also distributive law to here. So now in that case, whatever the duplication is there, we can remove. It is a P and negation Q. It is again P and negation Q, or negation Q and P. So we can just replace P and Q and or P and negation Q, or negation Q and negation P. For avoiding this, you want to avoid this duplication. So this term, it is in the form of principle of disjunctive normal form. So we can say there is no term which is other than main term. So what are the mean term? As we know, the mean term is P and Q, P and negation Q, negation P and Q, and negation P and negation Q. If there is a two proposition variable, P and Q are exist, then there is a total four mean term. So it is come under the P and Q, P and negation Q, and negation P and Q. So that expression we can solve without using the truth table. So with the help of truth table, also generate the same output. So we can generate P, Q, P, or negation Q, and it is negation Q. So it is true, 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 false, false, true, false, false. Negation Q is false, true, false, true. P on negation Q, that is the first, this one and this one. P on negation Q, true or false, true, true and true, true, false, and false and true, it is true. Now we can generate the main term. So here, when true, true, the main term become P and Q. So, in case of P and negation Q, or it is negation P and negation Q. It is P and negation Q. So now it is the finally output is P or negation Q, which is equal to P and Q, or P and negation Q, or negation P and negation Q. So this is also equal to this one. So either we can solve with the help of truth table, or we can solve with the help of apply the different type of law of logic, that is De Morgan law, distributive law, and we can generate the final in the form of disjunctive normal form. So next you can take a few more example about the disjunctive principle of disjunctive normal form. So next example is that the P and Q, or it is negation P and R, or Q and R. Now this expression is given and we want to convert into the principle of disjunctive normal form. So what we can do, here in this example you know that there is one missing term in the P and Q, the R is missing. In negation P and R, the term Q is missing, and Q and R, here again the term P is missing. So what we can do, we can take first term P and Q, which is equivalent to P and Q and R or negation R. R or negation R is nothing but a tautology, because R or R is all the truth value should be generated as a true. Now, in that case, what we can do, we can again apply the distributive law. So, apply distributive law and we get P and Q and R, or P and Q and negation R. So now the expression is like that in the form of P and Q and R, and P and Q and negation R. Similarly, you can find negation P and R. Here the missing factor is Q. So it is equivalent to negation P and R, and it is Q or negation Q. And Q or negation Q is again tautology. So any term and Q, which is nothing but negation P and R. So again apply the distributive law and we get negation P and R and Q, or negation P and R and negation Q. And the final term, which is Q and R, which is equivalent to, here the missing factor is P. So in that case we can write Q and R, and it is a P or negation P. P or negation P is again tautology. So Q and R and true, which is generated as a Q and R. So there is no change, we can use and P or negation P. So now here we can apply the distributive law and we get Q and R and P, or Q and R and negation P. So now we can term both the term, we can add here. So what will be the final output? The final output is like that. P, we can just put here the final output, it is R and P and Q and negation R, or negation P and R and Q, or negation P and negation Q and R, or Q and R and P, or Q and R and negation P. So that is the final output, which is the value of P and Q, we can substitute this one, the another value is this one, and third value is this one. We can add these three value, so we can generate this is the equivalent expression. But that is not in the exactly PDNF, because the PDNF says ki if there is any duplicate entry, we can also remove that one. So here in this case, PQ and R, negation P, R, Q, and negation P, negation Q and R. This is the repeat entry and this is also repeat entry. So finally expression is P and Q and R, or P and Q and negation R, or negation P and R and Q, or negation P and negation Q and R. So this is the final form, which is called as a PDNF, principle of disjunctive normal form. So here in this example, we can take a one missing factor is one variable in P and Q. The R is missing here, the Q is missing here, the P is missing. So we can just use the tautology term R or negation R, and we can apply this expression after applying the distributive law, and similarly we can find the solution. So here the total number of variable is 3. And 3 variable, so total mean term is 2 to the power 3, which is nothing but 8 mean term. And this 8 mean term we can write in the different way. So here the proposition variable, 3 variable P, Q and R. So that problem we can solve with the help of 3 proposition variable. So here we can generate these are the mean term of the 3 variable. So now the next part we can discuss in the case of principle of disjunctive normal form, what the things we can do. First, we can convert this implication biconditional, convert into the conjunction, disjunction and negation, and apply the De Morgan law. And the finally principle disjunctive normal form we can apply in the mean term alone. That is the difference between the disjunctive and principle of disjunctive normal form. So next problem we can start with the principle of conjunctive normal form. Next is the principle of conjunctive normal form, and it is also called as a PCNF. In the principle of conjunctive normal form, here we can take, let we can take a two proposition variable P and Q. There is a two proposition variable, and we can write the in the principle of disjunctive normal form, it is nothing but a dual of mean term, and dual of mean term which is called as a max term. So here the whatever the max term are, P or Q, P or negation Q, negation P or Q, negation P or negation Q, so these are called as a max term. If the proposition variable are 2, then these are the max term, and if there is a n number of variable, so 2 to the power n number of max terms are exist. These are the way in which we can solve the principle of conjunctive normal form. So what is the difference between the principle of disjunctive normal form and principle of conjunctive normal form? In principle of disjunctive normal form, we can use the mean term. But in principle of conjunctive normal form, we can use the dual of mean term, that is a max term, in which we can use P or Q, P or negation Q, negation P or Q, negation P or negation Q, where the proposition variable is 2, P and Q. If there is a 3 proposition variable, then we can use the 8 total number of max term. And each of the max term has a truth value F, exactly one combination of including all the variable in it. So all the variables we have to take exactly one truth value which is contained as a false. But in principle of disjunctive normal form, only one truth value tree for every combination including the variable itself. So we can solve with the help of truth table. There is a P and Q two proposition variable, and P or Q P or negation Q, negation P or Q, negation P and negation Q. It is a true true, true false, false true, and false false. P or Q, it is true, 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 false. P or negation Q, true and false, true. And it is a seen true, it is a false, and it is again false. It is again, it is a false and true, it is a true. Now negation P, false, true, it is a false, it is a true, and it is a true. Negation P, false, and remaining all are the true. So you know that in this table exactly one in one combination, each combination exactly one value is truth value is false, remaining all are the true. Here in this combination only one truth value is false, in this combination only one value is false, in this combination again one value become false. So in principle of conjecture normal form, exactly one value truth value become false. So in the max term P or Q, only one value false. P or negation Q, it is false for the false and true. In that case we can find the truth value. So how we can generate, we can take a P implies Q and we can generate the principle of conjecture normal form for the implication. So here we can take PQ, P implies Q, it is true true, true false, false true, and false false. When P implies Q become true, when both the truth value is true, then it is true. Or when the value of P become false, no matter what the value of Q has. So here it is false, it is true, no matter what the value of Q has. And in other case it is false. So what is the max term? So when both the true, it is true, and max term is, so in that case we can generate the max term. So true and false, it is generate here false, negation P or Q. It is a negation P or Q, where true and false, it is a false. So we can say P implies Q equal to negation P or Q. So that is the form of, we can call as a principle of conjective normal form. Similarly, when we can find the P biconditional Q. So here the truth value, here in the case truth value are true, same at that time the true, otherwise it is false. So what is the max term? True and false, it is false, it is called a negation P or Q, and false and true, it is false, it is called as a P and negation Q. And this one. So here it is a false, true and false, it is false, where the max term is negation P or Q. So negation P or Q, and false and true, where the max term is P or negation Q. So here we can say P biconditional Q equal to negation P or Q, and P or negation Q. So it is the form of, we can call as a principle of conjective normal form. So that is that type of problem we can solve with the help of truth table. Another way, without using the truth table, how to solve the problem of principle of conjective normal form. So now the next, we can start with the, without using the truth table, we can solve the expressions.
Yes.
The P and Q, or we can take the example, the P and P or Q. Now this example we can solve with the help of either truth table or with the help of, without using the truth table. So with the help of truth table, what we can do, we can take two proposition variable P and Q, it is true false, false true, and it is false false. Now It is P or Q. It is true and false. P or Q. That is true and true. It is true. Again true. It is false. It is false. Now, what is the next term? So, we can generate the max term where this one and this one. So, we can generate with the help of this table, we can generate the value is false, at that time it is P or negation Q, and that term is called as a P and Q. So, this term we can write in the form of principal consecutive normal form P and P or negation Q, which is equal to P or negation Q and P or Q. So it is the principle of conjunctive normal form. So now next problem is that how it we can solve without using the truth table. So what we can solve without using the truth table, it is a P and P or Q. So that expression we can solve with the help of truth table. Now how it, without using the truth table, how it will be solved? We can also write P or F and P or Q. So anything with the false, it is equivalent to P. You can just show it, the example, P, it is a truth or false value. F, it is both the false. P or F, it is equal to either true and false, which is nothing but equal to P. So P, as we know, P or F, which is nothing but P. So we can also write down here P or F and P or Q. So now we can write the expression P or Q or negation Q and P or Q. So Q and, I think it is a Q and negation Q, because Q or negation Q equal to tautology, and Q and negation Q, it is a contradiction. So here we can use the term P or F, we can write Q and negation Q. So now, in this expression, here we can apply, again, in this expression we can apply the distributive law, and after applying the distributive law, we can generate the output P or Q and P or negation Q. Or negation Q after applying the distributive law. And P or Q. So now, in this expression, we can apply the associative law. Because P or Q, we can shift here, we can write P or Q and P or Q and P or negation Q. So, as we know, P and P equal to P, that is an idempotent law. We can apply idempotent law, we can write here, it is a P or Q and P or negation Q. So, you know that this expression is equal to this expression. So, we can solve either based on the law of logic, or we can have them with the help of truth table. So, when the expression is so large, when the proposition variable is 3, 4, at that time the expression can be solved with the help of law of logic. So, that is in the form of, we can call it as a principle of conjunctive normal form. So I think you have clear about the concept. Now next problem we can discuss, which is again one problem we can take on the principle of conjunctive normal form. So the next problem we can solve with the help of conjunctive normal form. Now we can start with a negative normal form. So, in principle of conjunctive normal form, we can say When any expression is given, dual of min term is called a max term. If n number of proposition variable are exist, then there is a total 2 to the power n number of max term. If there is a 2 variable, then we can take the total 4 max terms. And in every combination, exactly one value become false. So now, the next part is called as a negative normal form. That is called NNF. So what is a negative normal form? A proposition formula A, propositional formula A, which is in NNF, if the implication connective connectives which are not used, implication connective not used, in A. If a proposition formula A is in NNF negative normal form, if implication connective are not used in A, then and that formula A, which is an atomic formula, which is cannot be broken down further. And the another thing is that the formula is in NNF, which is built-up form literals, constant, and Boolean algebra, that is 0 and 1, it is either true or false, or we can call it as 1 and 0. That is in the form of negative normal form. If a formula A is in NNF, we can also generate the B formula, which is also same in the case of NNF. So, this is the regarding concept of the negative normal form. So in next class we can discuss the what is an argument and how to check the validity of the argument. Thank you.